This is Old Spice College Lacrosse. And when you play lacrosse at Virginia and Syracuse, this is the game you cannot wait for, as the fastest sport on 2 feet gets a little bit faster when it's the Orange and the Cavaliers. And tonight, it's number one against number two. Hello and welcome to the Carrier Dome. I'm Eamon McEnany, along with Quint Kesenick. Paul Carcaterra will join us from the field momentarily. And Quint, there are many good and historic rivalries in the sport of college lacrosse. What makes this one so unique?
Hall of Fame caliber players, games with big-time implications and style. This game is played at hyperspeed. It is fan-friendly and entertaining.
Now, for Virginia, the strength, offense. Syracuse, defense, and both teams have two of the best players at their positions in the country.
Well, Steele Stanwyck for Virginia, he is the conductor of the Cavalier Offensive Symphony. Great vision, gifted hands. He is selfless. He makes his teammates better. 7 points against Stony Brook. For his career, he's averaged 3.5 points per game.
His overtime goal against the Seawolves is why Virginia is still undefeated. Joel White, a dual threat.
National midfielder of the year. Watch the takeaway check. He is a turnover creator, active stick, fleet feet. Disruption is his calling card. He is also an offensive threat.
And he will be involved in the marquee matchup in this game against number one, Shamel Bratton. Now let's check in with Paul Carcaterra down on the field, who's standing by with Syracuse head coach, John Desco.
Coach, strength on strength. You have Joel White on defense. Virginia rolls out Shamel Bratton, the most explosive midfielder in the game. What do you expect out of this matchup?
Well, I think you're going to see people running up and down the field. Two great athletes, probably maybe the two best athletes in the game of lacrosse today. In a dry surface here in the Carrier Dome, no rain, no snow. Let's go at it. Let's have some fun.
Thanks, Coach.
There it is. Let's go at it. Let's have some fun. Now let's take a look at our impact players brought to you by Warrior.
Steele Stanwyck, fourth in the nation in points per game. Shamel Bratton, the most elusive midfield dodger in the country. He is Kemba Walker with a lacrosse stick. Chris LaPierre, the human clear, a one-man band. He'll face off, play defense, play offense. He's a beast. For Syracuse, JoJo Marasco wears number 22. Explosive sophomore is unpredictable. He's the Orange's best penetrator. Jeremy Thompson, instant offense off the face-off, and Joel White can run all night.
78 ground balls a year ago. Virginia comes in 4-0. Syracuse 2-0. A great crowd on hand tonight at the Carrier Dome. They told the fans to arrive early. Message delivered, message sent. Virginia, coached by the Hall of Famer Dom Starzha, 7 wins away from passing our colleague Jack Emmer for the most career wins all time at a Division I lacrosse school. His team last year making it all the way to championship weekend, losing to Duke in the semifinals. Virginia in the road blue, Syracuse in the throwback uniforms. Thompson, number 4, wins the big hit to start. And I believe a Syracuse player came out of the box before there was possession. And I was wrong. So Syracuse ball first. This is White. Finally, McDermott decides to pick him up.
His face-off trio for Syracuse, dangerous when they carry in.
Look at White there drawing the double team in the slide. This is Thompson. Now Thompson will wait. As Josh Amadon checks in, he has the ball right now, number 9. Senior out of Lafayette, New York. He has it again now. This is the first midfield group. Jovan Miller, Josh Amadon, and Jeremy Thompson with the ball. Amadon with space, goes to his right hand. The attack for Syracuse is number 22, JoJo Marasco, Keo, and Tim Desco.
Keys for the Cuse, push the Brattons to weak angles down the alley, low percentage shots, and move off ball on offense to confuse this inexperienced Virginia D.
Marasco going back to his right. The swim move being covered by number 40, Matt Lovejoy. And Lovejoy causes a turnover. LaPierre the ground ball.
Lovejoy wins round one.
So the Cavaliers make a stand. LaPierre, a great athlete in the open field. So now LaPierre gets off the field after the stop. This is Chris Bocklet with the ball.
Cavalier keys shoot on target versus John Galloway, the nation's top goalie, especially early in this game. And then cover and defend behind the goal, specifically the matchups with JoJo Marasco and Tom Palasek.
So now the Cavaliers' top midfield group is out there. This is Shamel Bratton with the ball. White comes out on him. He is joined by his brother, Ramel Bratton, and number 12, John Haldy. So now Bratton taking a run at White. Back to his left. Oversell on the right, shooting the bounce shot, and Virginia is on the board first.
Historically, when Shamel and Ramel get off to good starts, look out. He's a left-handed player. The rollback is there. Double team from Syracuse is late, and they don't take the body. Shamel is known for that rollback, and when the double doesn't come, he puts himself dead center at 10 yards. Nothing Galloway could do.
His fifth of the season, seventh career goal against Syracuse. First time all year Syracuse has trailed, and there's a violation on the faceoff. Thompson gives it up to White. Thompson's free, 6-on-5 right now until LaPierre gets back in.
Tell you, when Joel White turns Shamel Bratton, and you can see the number one and the name S. Bratton on his back, that's when the defense has to go.
Pick play opportunity. There's a shot and a goal. Tim Desko evens things up. Miscommunication on the defensive end by the Cavs, and the Orange take advantage.
The coach's son, a little pick set by Marasco, effectively blocks both defenders right here. Communication, an issue. Simple two-man game leads to a high percentage shot from Desko.
18 seconds between goals. We are off and running at the Carrier Dome between number one and number two.
Pick rules in lacrosse identical to what they are in basketball. Defensively, it's either a switch or a stay and fight through.
McDermott actually won the clamp, but Thompson beat him to the ground ball, and then White picks it up, so another possession for the Orange. This is Kevin Drew. And JoJo Marasco has it behind, being guarded by Lovejoy. Basically 5-on-5 right now as McDermott shutting off Joel White at around the 40-yard line for the football field. Now White's all alone. He drops it off to Steve Ionzito. Syracuse gets its second midfield unit out there. Jeff Gilbert on the field, number two. And they'll be joined by number 27, Pete Coleman.
Point of emphasis for John Desko when we spoke to him this week, trying to get some production from the second midfield. They have not done well this year, to say the least. Only one goal as a group.
Conversely, the top midfield unit has 9 goals in 2 games. And here's a shot for Ionzito. High to high. He blows that one by Adam Gittleman. And Syracuse has the lead.
This is big. Running north-south downhill parallel to the football hash marks. Defensively, you want to get him off his intended pathway and push him towards the pylon in the corner of the end zone. Jubilant reaction for Syracuse. Key production from a complimentary player.
His first career goal, a local product. Went to Cicero North Syracuse High School, so he breaks through. So the second line doesn't waste any time making a contribution. Mix-up on the faceoff here. Look at Coach John Desko, who had said, told us on our conference call and publicly that if they don't pick it up, he's going to make some changes with that second unit. So they produced right now.
He has got a stable of young freshmen trying to earn their way on that second group.
Chris Daddio, one of those freshmen out there taking the faceoff now against Ryan Benacasa. So a new look here at the X. Same result. Joe White there for a Syracuse ground ball.
He is everywhere. He can run all day. Talking to their strength and conditioning coach, Hal Luther, who works with football and lacrosse here at Syracuse, said Joel White is a world-class athlete cardio-wise. He put him against any athlete in soccer or football that he has ever trained.
So Pete Coleman out there, 27, along with Miller. Amidon being guarded by LaPierre. Amidon gets a pick. Amidon going hard, now gives it up. Lovejoy fights through the pick on Marasco, feed inside. Keogh made the catch, but he didn't pull the trigger. This is Coleman. There's a bounce shot, just off the mark. Syracuse will retain possession. Virginia goalie Adam Gittleman, career record of 41-6, the most wins ever by a Virginia goalie.
Unbeaten in three starts, head-to-head against Syracuse and John Galloway, did not start or play in the 2008 NCAA semifinal. Virginia's goalie was Bud Petit.
Marasco back to the left hand, goes for some trickeration off the mark, and good hustle there by Virginia, so it'll be blue ball.
Marasco presses the corner right-handed. You see Lovejoy trying to lift and get under that bottom glove. Famed number 22 jersey started back in the late 80s with Gary Gate, worn by Casey Powell, Ryan Powell, Mikey Powell, and the sophomore from Westchester County now wearing the magical 22.
Changed his number, wore number one last year while Cody Jamison wore the double deuce, as it's affectionately called up here in Central New York. Almost an unforced turnover there as the freshman Rob Emery runs it down. So Emery's out there along with Shamel Bratton. And Colin. Sort of a mixed unit here. Emery usually runs on the second line. A talented freshman out of San Francisco has the ball. This is Chris Bocklet. Coming off a 7-point effort against VMI. Now Briggs going at Kevin Drew. Feed inside, shot, goal! Mark Cochran evens things up at two.
Dom Starzia could not have been more complimentary about Colin Briggs when we spoke to him this week. Really emerging as an offensive threat, a strong 6-foot, 200-pound right-handed midfielder draws the double team, and there is no second slide by Syracuse. Cochran just fills that space, catches and finishes the lefty freshman from Canada.
Seventh goal already in his young Virginia career. Ranked as the number three incoming freshman by Inside Lacrosse. His father, one of the legends in the game, Stan Cochran, scored 193 career goals at North Carolina State back in the 70s. Here's Thompson. Feed inside, catch made, Desco again! One of the more creative players on the squad comes through there.
In an era of specialization where face-off players typically win a face-off and sprint off the field, meet Jeremy Thompson, instant offense. He pops the face-off clean, carries in, draws the eyes of the defense. Desco does the rest. Thompson is a huge matchup issue. Desco has shown a flair for some fancy finishes over the last 2 years.
He certainly has. Last year's goal against Princeton at the Big City Classic, one of the goals of the year, if not the goal of the year. But now a face-off opportunity for LaPierre in Virginia. Good transition defense by Syracuse. 12 seconds apart the last two goals. Last year, Jeremy Thompson was involved in 5 goals in 7 seconds or less. One this year against Denver, scoring right off the faceoff in 6 seconds.
The interior defense for Virginia against Keogh and Desco. I mean, you've basically got to be holding their jersey, grabbing their stick right in their grill.
John Haldy gives it up. Bocklet. We have not mentioned the name Steele Stanwyck very much as he's about to get the ball. John Lade ready to pounce on him. So here is number 6, Stanwyck, the junior out of Baltimore. Being guarded by an All-American defenseman, John Lade.
I love Lade's game. He's an absolute tenacious worker.
Nice feed, Bocklet made the catch, but fell into the crease and didn't get much of a shot off of. Let's go down to Paul Carcaterra.
Well, Eamon, Tim Desko decided to come to Syracuse and have the opportunity to play for his father. Plenty of doubters outside of the program. Tim mentioned the behind-the-back whispers were pretty bad the first couple of years. He's proven now he's one of the team's top scoring options, obviously has a flair for the dramatic with highlight reel-type goals. Teammates mentioned he's just one of the guys, and his father is very proud of the way he's handled this situation.
Coming off his first career hat trick against Army. And we've spoken to several coaches over the years, Bill Tierney, John Donowski, who have had the opportunity to coach their sons, and they said it's the greatest experience of their coaching career.
It can be difficult, it can be challenging. For the student athlete, Coach Desko told us last year that Timmy doesn't come home that much because he's heard and seen enough of Dad by the time the weekend rolls around. He'll stop by the home to drop off the laundry for Mom, but that's about it.
Coach Desko, a Syracuse native, went to West Genesee High School, as well as did his son. There's a good check by Lovejoy, putting it on the rug, and Gittleman hustles out to come up with it.
Great play by Gittleman. Really one of the strong parts of both goalies today are their play out of the net.
Errant pass by the freshman Scott McWilliams, so we go the other way.
Cavaliers clearing at 95% this year. Led the nation in that category last year, so a really uncharacteristic clearing error.
This is Amidon being guarded by LaPierre. Romel Bratton out there on Jovan Miller. Here's Amidon going to his right. That shot bounces in. How did that one go in? We're going to have to, now they're waving it off.
The goal's going to stay. Amidon, Major League Lacrosse draft pick. Bounce shot just goes off of Clement's head. That shot had absolutely no chance to score. It kicks off of Chris Clements, number two in blue. Hits him right in the helmet, right off the shoulder. Gettleman is trying to catch that ball, and his momentum's going too strong to his right. He can't get back, and a fluky goal.
Dom Starzer getting the explanation from one of our officials, Kevin O'Leary. So definitely a fluke goal in here.
Rough start for Adam Gittleman. Eighth round draft pick in Major League Lacrosse. There are a ton of seniors in this game who are selected by Major League Lacrosse. If you're Gittleman right now, you just want to settle down. The next shot is the one that matters.
Syracuse has won 5 of 6 faceoffs. Still loose here. Good ground ball pickup by Bray Malfris. But there's a call on Virginia, so the Cavs give it right back. Quint, what adjustments can Dom Starzer do at the X right now with Syracuse dominating that ground ball situation?
Well, he has options. You know, one thing Virginia has are a bunch of face-off specialists. They have three guys, Ryan Benincasa. You've seen McDermott. You also have Garrett Ince. And Chris LaPierre can take face-offs as well. So besides just the draw, though, you know, you got to find number 11 in Joel White, and you got to run him off the ball. You just need better effort. If I'm Virginia, I put my best athletes on the wings, Rommel and Chamel, and I let Chris LaPierre scrap, or I think Benincasa may be the ultimate guy today because he's the most balanced of their face-off specialists.
This is JoJo Marasco. Now he gives it up to Ian Zito. There's a lefty shot high.
The Ian Zito looks the part. 6'1", 207, Cicero, North Syracuse.
Here's Coleman being guarded by Rommel Bratton, number 3. Coleman out of New Jersey, taking a run at him down the alley. Now Marasco. Marasco falls down, Lovejoy all over him. Marasco feed inside to Keough. Good defense by Virginia, forcing the ground ball. Now LaPierre. Third turnover of the game for Syracuse. LaPierre being guarded by Ian Zito.
Ian Zito's got a little injury, something going on with his right hamstring.
Chamel's out of the box, hits the pipe. That one was a laser. Good job by McWilliams to hustle to the ground ball, but again, there's that man, number 11. But it'll be Virginia ball.
Joel White happens to be there because he is substituting and waiting for the midfielder. just a left-handed blast from 12 yards that nobody is going to keep up with.
John Galloway did not react until he heard that one hit the pipe right next to him. That one was cooking.
Shamel, a little snake bit shooting so far this season, shooting around 20% as a team. Virginia shoots 34%.
Selected by the Boston Cannons in Major League Lacrosse. Fourth overall pick. This is Cockerton giving it up to Stanwyck. Three and a half minutes left in the first quarter. Number two Virginia trails number one Syracuse, and they throw it away. And Clemens went offsides, going over the line. There's a restart for Harder in the Cuse. This is Kevin Drew with the ball.
A very fortunate whistle for Virginia as Marasco and the Orange were off to the races.
Now, why'd they blow the whistle? Because when he went offsides, there was no possession?
Yeah.
So now Jovan Miller being guarded by Haldy. Shake and bake to his left. Keeps going hard. Gets his hands free. Puts the bounce shot past Gittleman. The Orange lead by three.
Senior class getting it done. On a national scale, Jovan Miller is one of my favorite players because his game doesn't have boundaries. Ground ball play, defense, offense, and you talk about improvement over the course of a career. He is just such a focused young man on improving as a lacrosse player.
Jovan Miller in the Cuse up by three. There's a timeout on the field. We'll be back to Syracuse right after this.
The second annual ESPNU Warrior Classic returns to East Hartford, Connecticut on Saturday, April 23rd. Don't miss this top-level lacrosse doubleheader. UMass is back in search of a repeat victory, but will lacrosse powerhouse Hofstra be too much to handle? Then, 10-time national champion Syracuse faces up-and-coming Big East rival Rutgers. Be there April 23rd at Rentschler Field. Get your tickets now. Call 1-800-745-3000 or visit Ticketmaster.com today.
This phone was inspired by you. You're addicted to fast. You have a dog named Wi-Fi. And to you, buffering is a dirty word. You need a phone that can not only keep up, but blast ahead at 4G speeds. A phone that can turn an invitation into an experience. And a party into a, remember that time? The HTC Thunderbolt, exclusively on Verizon's blazing 4G LTE network. Made just for you.
Baseball tonight's got spring fever. From the cactus to the grapefruit. Who's going to break out? Who'll round out your rotation? The countdown to opening day is on. Baseball tonight, weekdays at 3:30 on ESPN.
We are ready to go again. What do you think Dom Starks' message was to his team here? As we have Thompson, instant offense. He shoots, good check. The trail check denies the shot opportunity.
Settle down would be his first message to his team. A couple uncharacteristic turnovers. I talked to Dom Starja on the ESPNU lacrosse podcast, and he was worried about his inexperienced defense and some youngsters in the lineup on offense playing in this atmosphere. This is a very unique and special place. 15,000 fans, national implications. He thought the first 10 minutes could be a little dicey for them.
Let's check in with Paul for more on Virginia as we get a shot and a goal. Chris Bocklet settles things down for Virginia.
If you're a young player and you watch our games on ESPNU this year, focus on the shooting motion and fundamentals of a guy like Chris Bocklet. I believe Ramel Bratton draws the double. Bocklet steps out towards the ball, meets it, jump shot seamlessly, singes that lower corner. That's as smooth, as accurate, as fundamentally sound as you'll ever see.
He now has 16 on the season. For more on Virginia, let's check in with Paul.
Well, Coach Starzer was pretty fired up during that timeout. He addressed his team, told them, relax, play defense, make sure you're collapsing on the midfield Dodgers of Syracuse. We're seeing success for Syracuse up top with guys like Amadon and Miller and Ionzito all scoring on midfield dodging goals. He wants help from the defenders and to come early and collapse.
There's a good double team by John White, forcing a ground ball. Stanwyck, though, there to pick it up for Virginia. Under 2 minutes to play here in the first quarter.
Very valid points by Coach Starz. Your three unassisted midfield goals. The Amadon goal, kind of fluky. But the Jovan Miller goal, maybe a little more disconcerting. He's a natural left-handed player. You gave him his strong hand. You didn't get a double there.
Riggs with the swim move, keeps it going, draws the flag. Virginia will play on until the ball comes out of the box, as Shamel Bratton could not pick up the ground ball. So good aggressive take there by Colin Briggs, and we'll see Dom Starge's extra man unit. As we see Steve Miller make the call. He'll be hold for 30 seconds.
32.
Dom Starge's extra man unit has been excellent so far this year, Quint.
That's an understatement. 13 of 16, 81% in four games. Briggs leans in. He cannot be stopped by a short stick, and teams are eventually going to have to start shifting the pole on Colin Briggs.
There you see Emery, the freshman out there. He's got one of the best shots on the team, if not the best shot on the team. Matt White also out there, number four. Virginia being patient. Penalty released. Emery shoots as advertised.
I could not believe what I was seeing yesterday in Virginia's shoot around. Penalty had expired, but Virginia maintains their poise and patience. And watch Emery. This kid is an absolute future superstar. High heat, little sidearm. Gets the full body torque. Look at that wrist snap from St. Ignatius in San Francisco, an emerging hotbed out west. Tall and thin, reminds me of a young Josh Sims, who was the star for so long at Princeton.
Alex Capretta at Princeton, Roy Lang at Cornell, also products of the San Francisco school. Now Clemens going the other way for Virginia, still has it as he gets hammered by Lade. So Virginia has turned the tables now, and the Cavaliers have the momentum. Here's Shamel.
Too many unforced errors by the Cavaliers. Amazing that the Brattons now have combined for 120 career goals between the two of them, and only three times has the assist come from the twin brother out of 120 career goals. Obviously most of their goals have been scored unassisted.
Good hustle back by Bray Malfus there, as Amadon was all alone from about 10 yards away. 11 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Back and forth we go. Syracuse had a run of three unanswered goals. Now Virginia with two. And Syracuse gets one back. It's Keough.
This is an example of tremendous game management by Syracuse's offense. Marasco glances up at the clock. 11 seconds to go. They do a little pick inside. As I said earlier, Virginia's interior defense has been just a little lax, a little too much space for guys like Desco and Stephen Keough. The Canadian can catch and finish.
One of the best finishers in the country, as you saw there, over 100 career goals. This faceoff is won by Syracuse, and that'll do it for the first quarter. So far here tonight, number one against number two, living up to the billing. Not a fun night so far for the goalies. Tim Desco and the Cuse with the two-goal lead. But Virginia can score in bunches. The second quarter coming up, and this one's bringing up memories of one for the ages. We go back in time to look at a high-scoring affair in this rivalry.
ESPNU is the home court of Championship Week.
Lady Volunteers, your 2010 SEC Women's Tournament champions.
Whose quest for this year's SEC title will continue?
Looking for three. Got it.
The conference's best face off for an automatic chance to dance. The SEC Women's Semifinals live from Bridgestone Arena in Nashville today at 4 and 6:30 on ESPNU. The home court of Championship Week, presented by Dick's Sporting Goods.
We all have times when we feel weak and run down.
Okay, I need a break. Can I just sit down for a second?
So what if I told you that regaining your strength and feeling renewed was as easy as wearing this?
That's crazy.
This is great.
All of these people are excited about iRenew, the revolutionary bracelet that uses natural frequencies to promote strength and wellness.
Just watch these strength and balance tests. Without iRenew, these people couldn't even stay on their feet. After slipping iRenew on, they were amazed at how their balance was instantly restored. And these aren't actors, just regular people experiencing iRenew's effects for the first time.
Highly recommended.
Athletes and celebrities have paid hundreds, even thousands of dollars, but now you can get your iRenew for just $19.99, and we'll send you a second one free. Just pay separate processing. If it doesn't work exactly like you've seen in this commercial, send it back for a full refund. No questions asked. You get two iRenew bracelets, a $40 value for just $19.99. Call now.
Game that has defined a rivalry. Let's go down to someone who played in that game and came up with 1-1.
Well, if you were a defensive purist, that was not the game for you. It was an electric night. The one I probably remember most in the Carrier Dome. We were down by 5 or 6 goals in that second half. There was a buzz and a feeling that we were going to make a run. Both sides had some epic ball players as well. You mentioned Casey Powell, Rob Cavitt, guys like Matt Cione and Ryan Powell for Syracuse. Virginia, Watson, Knight, some of the best ball players of all time. It was a special evening. I'll always remember that one.
So far, it looks like we might have another special one here. Huge development in this game as Gittleman makes his first save of the evening. While we were away, a stick check on number 41, Mark Cockerton. Illegal pocket, so Virginia is down a man for 1 minute. So they get the save, and now Ramel Bratton will try to run off as much time in this penalty. So this would be huge if Virginia can get through this without giving up a goal.
Go back to that 97 game. There were only 3 pockets of kind of quiet action in that game. The goal scoring was fast and furious right from the opening faceoff.
Enjoyed talking to Dom Starzer about that game. He said he was in the huddle saying, guys, it's not against the rules to slow it down. And he could just tell they were not listening to anything he was saying. They wanted to run and gun that night. So Syracuse gets it back, still up a man. Now the penalty's released. Amidon wheels and deals. Gittleman gets 2 quick ones. Briggs going the other way. He's got Cochran coming out of the box. Catch made. Goal. Galloway gets a piece. A huge save by the senior All-American right there.
Taya Cockerton, as you called it, the penalty's released, so all of a sudden, Virginia had 4 guys on the offensive side of the field, and only 3 Syracuse defenders. Look at Galloway. That upper hand quickness, popping that stick in front of his face.
Welcome to Division I lacrosse, young man. You probably didn't get stuff like that in the high school level. Galloway, the first Syracuse goalie. He's a shot, another save, his third of the night. Be awarded as the nation's best goalie since 1925. Here he is, Joel White. Instant offense going the other way. He still has it. Shoot. Shot blocked. End-to-end action by number 11. Syracuse comes up with the ground ball. Amidon settles things down over to Desco.
Okay, a nice play by Amidon. Joel White maybe tried to do a little too much, but how about this crowd? 15,000 fans on their feet as White carried into the offensive zone.
That is what they came to see. Excellent atmosphere here. Good representation by the student body dressed in orange.
And you felt it on campus today. Walking around campus, went up to Manly Fieldhouse. Everybody talking about this game. This is the one they've been pointing to since the football season ended.
So now you see JoJo Marasco coming up to play at the midfield. Tom Palasek, number 14, is on the field at attack. So Jovan Miller being guarded by LaPierre. Here comes Miller looking to take a run. Draws the switch. Clements all over him, forces the pass. Now here's Marasco up top. Normally an attack, but now coming from up top. Draws the slash, as you can hear that one in the top row. Now Marasco gets a step. Marasco splits the defense, shoots and scores! Too easy for number 22.
Creative, explosive, and unpredictable. He told us, as you see the referee making the call, JoJo Marasco told us yesterday at practice when he's carrying in from up top or the wing, he's thinking for himself. That's where he's most comfortable, generating his own shot. Watch this change the direction, eyes up. He's got the strength, the power. There should be another foul right there. That was late and high. Marasco does it all himself. He's the right.
Polio, 17 points in just 10 games last year. The reigning Big East Offensive Player of the Week. Now has 11 points in three games. The product of Somers, New York.
Big personality, too. Loves this game. Loves wearing 22 at Syracuse after an early verbal commit to Ohio State. Joe Bresci then takes the North Carolina job. A bunch of other schools get involved. And late in the process, relatively late in the process, John Desco knocks him up.
Big hit there as Drew laid out LaPierre, but now a turnover. Ramel Bratton upside to Stanwyck on the doorstep and a goal and a late hit there. Stanwyck got popped. So a rare turnover for Syracuse leads to a Stanwyck goal.
Nice handle by Ramel Bratton, creating this turnover off a sloppy outlet pass. The exclamation point. You see the patience by Stanwyck.
So maybe not as easy as the game winner against Stony Brook, but certainly taking advantage.
And you see the good sportsmanship. Laid the senior. Stanwyck understands that that wasn't intentional. His flopping there may have been trying to draw the foul. There's a mutual respect, tremendous mutual respect.
This is Shamel Brett, being guarded by Tim Harder. So man down goal for Virginia. Makes it a 7-5 ball game as you see Shamel Bratton running around, trying to avoid the double team. For one off all of this penalty on Bray Malfris for the slash. Under 11 minutes to play in the half. Shamel's going to back it up in no rush. Gets above goal line extended, hit the pipe. That's two pipes now for number one. Guadagnolo now in the open field. He's got it. He's going to shoot. And Gittleman stops it. Now we go the other way. This is Briggs. He's got Cochran again coming out of the box. Doesn't see him. Cross pass. Knocked away. Good job by Lade. Stanwyck runs it down. Big hit by McGill, but he draws the flag. That'll be a push with possession. So an extra man opportunity as Kevin O'Leary makes the call. So McGill goes to the box, and ESPNU's coverage of college lacrosse continues Saturday afternoon as number 10 Princeton takes on number 8 Johns Hopkins. Old Spice College Lacrosse Saturday at 1 Eastern as the Tigers and Blue Jays return to Homewood Field. Coach Chris Bates hoping to get Chris and Jack McBride back on the field. Tigers coming off a tough road loss to Seth Tierney's Hofstra Club. So Emery's pass gets knocked down. This is Eilers giving it up to Guadagnolo. Nice pass, but the catch cannot be made by Desco. So Virginia will be unable to take advantage of this extra man opportunity as White gets it into the box. Matt White, number four, sophomore out of Ridgefield, Connecticut. Now Shamel being guarded by Jovan Miller. It looks like he wants to line him up and take him to the rack. Two of the best athletes in the sport.
Who's ready to support? Who's ready to double for Syracuse?
Doesn't give him time to come. Quick release. Low to high. He has two.
It's early March, but so far, team defense sold separately in this ball game. You could sense this play coming a mile away. Bratton posts up against Jovan Miller. If he's at that hash mark, you've got to flush him and make him a passer. Gets to his strong left-handed shot. A pair of future pros, just too easy for Shamel Bratton. You want to make him a passer when he has the ball on the wing.
Great camera work on that shot as Virginia pulls within one with 9:21 to play. When we come back, we'll look around the country at other college lacrosse headlines. It's number one leading number two here at the Cuse.
USC cheerleading is highly competitive. I tore my ACL in April 2010. I also damaged my meniscus and had to have reconstructive surgery, and that was a huge life-changing experience. It made me appreciate the sport and appreciate the ability for me to bounce back, and it's awesome to be back. No, not now.
Nothing's worse than a dead battery. And nothing's more reliable than a Duralast battery. Duralast, proven tough, only at AutoZone.
Meet Kate, mild-mannered mother of two. Kate spent her days working at two low-wage jobs. Without higher education, Kate was always worried about her future. One night, while struggling to stay ahead of her expenses, Kate found the answer. By logging on to this website, she found hundreds of online and campus universities that helped her discover her future. They also had free valuable information, like a guide to grants and scholarships, and annual earning statistics for all degree levels. Kate also learned great study tips that helped her maximize her higher education. She discovered that getting a bachelor's degree can double her weekly income, and that college graduates, on average, can earn substantially more than non-graduates over a lifetime. So what are you waiting for? Call the number on your screen to start your education in a field you love. Call now and find the answers to your higher education future today.
The 16-time champs are on the hunt for another Big East crown. Will anyone be able to shock the Huskies for a spot in the finals and an automatic tourney bid? The Big East Women's Semifinals, Monday on ESPNU.
Face-offs are a team exercise. Wing play critical. Right here.
White kicks it in. Big hit by Gittleman, and Malfres comes up with it, so Gittleman gets called for a penalty. Must have been a cross check. I think he led with the stick. Coach Desko thinks he wanted a play on, so Gittleman will serve the penalty. So number 18, Rob Fortunato, will most likely go in.
That's twice in the last 2 minutes that we've seen pushes from behind with possession. McGill ran over a Virginia offensive player. This is a ground ball scrap. This is a playoff quality ground ball scrap. Watch Joe White. Little soccer background. He pays the price on the sideline. Keeping that ball alive. Gittleman with the push. Fortunato played the entire Drexel game. Played very well.
This is Desko. Inside for Thompson. Now Desko up top. Aminon. Aminon takes the righty shot. Blocked by Clements. He loses his stick. Unsettled opportunity. Marasco picks it up. Looks away. Looks immediately for Keogh, but the pass gets knocked down. A And Ramel Bratton comes up with the critical ground ball.
Two nice defensive plays. Clements, first of all, blocks the shot. What a great story he is. Converted midfield, now playing defense. And then Malfris with the excellent trail check on Keogh inside.
Clements missed all of last season with a serious knee injury.
Played defense in high school, St. Paul's in Baltimore. Switched to midfield his junior and senior year where he tore that league up. And now he's back to his defensive position. Coach Starja called him into the office in January.
Now Stanwood
said, "You're not in trouble, son. We're switching your position."
His father and grandfather, both All-American goalies at Washington and Lee. Told me they never really forced him, though, to get into the cage. Grab the stick. This is Ramel.
He had more sense than...
That's exactly what he said. I'd let you say that. As Ramel Bratton goes back to his right, got a good look. I think that hit a pipe as well. That's exactly what he said. He said, "I wasn't crazy enough." Number one against number two, living up to the history of this rivalry. Very tight one as Virginia leads the series 14-12. The Cavs have won 7 of the last 8 meetings. But that last win, though, a semifinal overtime thriller that helped lead Syracuse to a national championship.
The all-time goals in the series right now, after 26 and almost a half meetings, tied, exactly tied.
Stanwood coming around, gets poke checked. Marasco was back there on defense. Now in the open field, David Hamlin to White.
The overall number now is 353-353.
Let's wait for that math.
In 26 meetings. This being the 27th.
Last year was a one goal thriller, 11-10 down in Charlottesville. Here's Palasek. Rocky Point, New York. Enrolled at Syracuse in January. After his first 2 years at Johns Hopkins. JoJo Marasco again up top. Clements comes out to guard him. Marasco goes by him. Back to his left. Let's send it down to Paul Carcaterra.
On that last timeout, Coach Desko emphasizing better shooting, efficiency, canning in close shots, really telling his players, change your levels. If your stick's high, shoot low. He wasn't happy. There was 4 in a row where guys came down on slow breaks and shot it right in Gittleman's stick.
This is Keogh, left-handed. He is a strong right-handed player. Got a little Mohawk action going for this game. A thinner, more fit Stephen Keogh this season as well. Was very proud of that yesterday at the walkthrough.
Very excited to tell us he's dropped about 10 pounds. Working hard on the core, he told us. Here's Clements on the clear. And Virginia was offsides as Briggs went over. If the officials didn't make that call, 15,000 people wearing orange certainly did. Virginia's 7th turnover of the ball game. Under 5.5 to play here in the first half. McGill can't bring it in. Good pop there by Keogh. But he draws the whistle. Bocklet up ahead to White. White being guarded by David Hamlin.
Syracuse led the nation last year in scoring defense, 7.4 goals against average per game.
Well, Pierre can't keep his feet, then he pounces back right up and shoots it high. That's why you don't have fans in the end zone at the Carrier Dome. Those shots can sail in the first couple rows. Stanwood, a quick restart.
How about the orange seat backs? I mean, where was that when I was playing here? You can actually see the ball
the
here
gripes.
Now.
Here it comes.
It's like a hitter's eye in baseball. The silver seats for years were the goalie's worst nightmare.
And there's a shot by Briggs. Beating Galloway. We are all tied at 7.
Briggs is now a force to be reckoned with after dealing with a foot injury early in his career. The blow by, the poorly angled double team, and he didn't even have to pay the price. Briggs from Rhode Island.
His fourth goal of the season. He had 10 a year ago. Product of Bishop Hendrick in high school in Rhode Island. And a ground ball pickup for Virginia by Blake Riley. So Virginia takes a timeout with the key possession here, all even at 7 with just over 4 minutes to play.
India, let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
Get one more.
Tim Desko has a couple of goals already today, one of the creative variety, but last year the one against Princeton in the Big City Classic, the goal of the year.
A year ago, watch 21 in the slot, whoop, between the legs against Princeton in the opening of the Meadowlands. There it is. You probably got to see that on ESPN Sports Center, top 10 plays. Today, early success off the pick behind the net, and then you see the flair for the dramatic.
You know, a player like that who spent his whole life coming to the Carrier Dome and seeing the Gates and Marichek and the Pals, you know he's learned a thing or two from watching all that creativity.
And that's what has always been notable about Syracuse under John Desko and Roy Simmons, is a flair for the love of this game and being creative, trying something new, being innovative, and kids love it.
One of the players of that one of the products of that system, Paul Carcaterra.
Desko, he's actually a ball boy, would travel with us when I was a senior. I broke my stick mid-season in practice, and I was not too happy. When you get a stick as an offensive player, you love it, you want to hold on to it. Tim Desko actually gave me his stick. He had a nice one strung up, newly fresh, right out of a store. Handed it to me. I used it the rest of my senior year. Every time I see him, I always thank him for that gesture. And it's a funny little twist. Tim Desko, always a big fixture on the sidelines. His mother was always with us as well. Very family united type situation here at Syracuse. And Timmy Desko, big piece of that.
There was a good article this week by Dave Ramey of the Syracuse paper, who mentioned that for Christmas, Tim received a framed picture of that goal against Princeton. So I asked Coach Desko who gave it to him. Very quickly, he said, his mother. He said, I'm not going to give him a picture of that. So out of the timeout, Virginia with their top midfield line out there with the Brattons and Emery and Briggs. So a new look here. And another errant turnover. But White can't keep it in bounds.
Coach Starzha told us he would take an attackman out of the game and try to add an extra dodger on the field. So you have four midfielders and only two natural attackmen on the field. This creates all sorts of matchup problems. Both Brattons, Emery, and Briggs all have great speed.
Not a matchup problem here. All-American against All-American. Whoa, breaking ankles. Tim Harder there to recover. Now it's a matchup Virginia likes. Going back to the post up. Good double by McGill. Taking the body.
Should have done this the first time when Bratton curls up left-handed and tries to beat his man topside. You've got to go with the double team, rotate the defense, and then recover. Make him a passer.
Here's Emery. And Stanley. Feed inside, catch made, shot and a goal. Bocklet pays the price, but Virginia has the lead.
Stanwyck's been quiet. But here he presses the matchup and gets the eyes of the defense. Bocklet, you talk about a guy who's a nightmare to cover. Chris Bocklet is in constant motion, constantly moving. Galloway beat himself up pretty good after that ball went in the net.
Bocklet at one point in his career had 6 straight hat tricks until the Stony Brook game. Bounced back to have six goals. Montiero can't get the shot off. Had six goals against VMI, so he made up for it. And Syracuse will now take over. Virginia starting now to turn the tables at the faceoff. And out of that, they're on a 4-0 run to take the lead. Guadagnolo goes over. Gets it to Thompson. Thompson being guarded by Malfris. Gives it up to Palasek, who now draws Lovejoy. Miller, Thompson, Amidon. This is Desko out there along with Keo and Palasek. Here's Palasek. He has Lovejoy caught up in the crease, so Gittleman pops out. Good recovery by Virginia. Palasek back to his right. Tough angle. Gittleman makes the save. Number two, Virginia in blue on the road, taking on number one, Syracuse from the Carrier Dome. This is Old Spice College Lacrosse. Eamon McEnany, along with Quint Kesenick and Paul Carcaterra. Syracuse had the early lead, but Virginia now on a 4-0 run, up by a goal. Seventh meeting all time between these two storied programs. They are separated by just two goals in those meetings. The Syracuse senior class looking for their first regular season win. Huge asterisk next to that one against Virginia because they did knock them off in the postseason.
Talking to Dom Stargia on my ESPNU.com lacrosse podcast. So this is a game we don't obsess about. Whether we win or they win, our long-range goals will remain the same.
Under 30 seconds to play in an action-packed first half. Here's Haldy, the rocker, gets a step, makes the extra pass, another pipe.
That was a save. That was an unbelievable save.
An unbelievable save by John Galloway as you go the other way. I have no idea how he stopped that shot. Great recovery as we go the other way. Amidon puts on the brakes with 10. Now he's got to go. Miller can create with 5. Pass gets knocked down, unsettled opportunity. Gettleman ready for the save as time runs out. Back and forth we go. The goalies were getting peppered early, but now they have come alive late. Starting with Galloway as he kept this one a one-goal deficit for his team. Coming up on the Warrior Halftime Report, Ned Crotty will take a look at split dodges on the Warrior Pro Session. We'll have a preview of next weekend's Konica Minolta Face-Off Classic and, of course, highlights of an exciting first half in this one. And now let's go down to Paul Carcaterra, who's with Dom Stargia.
Coach, 5 out of your 8 goals came from the midfield. Do you continue to attack from up top?
I think we do. Well, you know, I think we have a little bit of a manpower advantage there. I think we certainly could try to get started there and see what happens. Obviously, we're not afraid to go through the attack. But I think we'll continue to come off the top in order to get us started.
Defensively, after Syracuse's early run, are you happy with the way that you adjusted?
I don't feel like we ever really played there in the first half, you know, and there were little mistakes at both ends. And early in the game, every mistake we made in the offensive end seemed to bite us in the defensive end, you know, and there were little communication things on defense. You might expect that, you know, kind of being a little frozen in a game like this early from our group there. I thought we loosened up a little bit in the second quarter. Did a nice job in transition defense because they had some opportunities and some extra man stuff that were able to hold them down. And so overall, I prefer not to have given up 7, but I thought we battled and I thought we started to kind of come together a little bit in the second quarter.
Thanks, Coach.
So Dom Stargia heads to the locker room up by 1. It could have been 2 except for a great save by John Galloway as the senior shows why he's an All-American. It's halftime of number 1 against number 2.
ESPNU is the home court of Championship Week.
Lady Volunteers, your 2010 SEC Women's Tournament
quest for this year's SEC title will continue.
Looking for three. Got it.
The conference's best face off for an automatic chance to dance. The SEC Women's Semifinals live from Bridgestone Arena in Nashville today at 4 and 6:30 on ESPNU. The home court of Championship Week presented by Dick's Sporting Goods.
Attention drivers, has your manufacturer's warranty expired or is it about to expire? Every mile you drive, your car is getting closer to needing costly repairs. How will you pay the hundreds, even thousands of dollars needed to get your car back on the road? Quick Auto Protection is here to help you with your financial needs. If your vehicle is less than 10 years old and has less than 150,000 miles on it, then we may still be able to offer you repair protection. Call now and we will connect you with one of our preferred extended protection providers. You choose the coverage and we'll tailor a plan to fit your budget. His transmission repair cost $3,300, but the owner paid nothing. 100% covered. When her car overheated, she called the shop and had her car towed. Just show your repair protection ID card and pay nothing. Repair costs are paid directly to your dealer or repair shop with no out-of-pocket costs to you. Save thousands in car repairs and keep your vehicle worry-free.
Call 800-218-7368 and get a free quote from a nationally recognized A-plus rated provider. There is no obligation. Call 800-218-7368 now.
Hi, I'm Mike Gleason inside the ESPNU studios. Thanks for watching ESPNU. For more information on this program and other ESPN sporting events, log on to ESPNU.com. We'll return to more action in this event after these messages.
The second annual ESPNU Warrior Classic returns to East Hartford, Connecticut on Saturday, April 23rd. Don't miss this top-level lacrosse doubleheader. UMass is back in search of a repeat victory, but will lacrosse powerhouse Hofstra be too much to handle? Then, 10-time national champion Syracuse faces up-and-coming Big East rival Rutgers. Be there April 23rd at Rensselaer Field. Get your tickets now. Call 1-800-745-3000 or visit Ticketmaster.com today.
Hello, ladies. Where can you go when your man smells like me? Close your eyes and I'll show you. Do you feel it? The sand between your toe tips? I do. Surprise! You're on a mountain peak. Why, play those sweet sha-la-las you love to hear. Firework colors turn our world upside down. I hope you like water, because we're neck deep in the sweet waters of friendship and trust. You see, when your man smells like the fresh scents of Old Spice, you can go anywhere. Unless, of course, you prefer to stay in.
You have 3 credit scores, and just one bad score can ruin everything. Get all 3 scores now at freescore.com.
Free score! Freescore.com!
Only one. The Big East Tournament first round live from Madison Square Garden, Tuesday at 7 and 9 on ESPNU, the home court of Championship Week.
Elite Lacrosse, North Carolina Princeton, Friday at 7 on ESPNU.
Still awaiting the first goal of the second half here after 15 in the first. Emery gets his hands free, but Galloway there for the save. Quinn, I know you spoke to Galloway this week on your ESPNU podcast. Now he was the best clearing goalie. Now he's just simply the best goalie.
He's improved his save percentage each year. As a freshman, 53% last year. He's right under 60. Great conversation with him. He's a perfectionist. His attention to detail is unmatched. He is his own harshest critic. And he is an absolutely driven student athlete. 3.5 GPA in public relations.
Two-man game to Keogh, and we're all tied again. That's why they call it execution. Senior to senior, we're all even.
Charismatic Canadian sets a pick and then flashes to the goal. Communication error for Virginia defense. See the pick? Little fake pick and slice to the net. Amadon picks up the assist. Keogh flexes his muscles.
That'll make your man Hal pretty excited to see him flexing the muscles. The strength and conditioning coach doing some extra work with Stephen Keogh in the preseason. So now a new face-off with Brian McDermott back out there. This is Riley looking for the scoop, and he comes up with it. But it looks like we're going to have a push on Virginia.
Interference call.
Interference.
There is nothing better.
Catch made. Desko scores.
The quick restart this time works in favor of the Cuse. And the junior has his second straight hat trick.
Quick start off the restart. You see the Virginia defender doesn't even have his equipment on. And Syracuse gets that ball, waits for the official's whistle, and then they are off to the races. Beat the whistle on restarts. Syracuse was ready. Virginia was not.
19 seconds between goals, so much for the scoring drought that was for more than 12 minutes over the second and start of the third quarter. Here's Marasco, gets inside. Look out. And there's a big hit by LaPierre. The shocker's going to the box. And now McWilliams has something to say.
I loved everything about JoJo Marasco except the finish. He likes his angles here. He gets underneath the defender.
Shot gets blocked by Lovejoy.
Shot got blocked. It didn't really help his angle. You can't hit a man while he's down, and you can't hit a man up by the neck and the head. Could be two potential fouls against Virginia.
28 white, technical push, 44 blue, 1 minute unnecessary. White ball, okay, it's white ball, two all fouls, even. All even. Five on five, 28.
So five on five for 30 seconds as Keogh got called for a penalty. Well, no, I thought he said 28 white.
So what's the
It is on Keogh as you hear Leland Rogers trying to get him off the field.
Hold it for 30 seconds. Run offense for 30.
So you heard Coach Desko, hold it for 30 seconds, then there'll be a man up. So the unnecessary roughness call on LaPierre, Keogh for 30 seconds.
Awesome job by our audio group. You see, right there could be a foul. They called Keogh for a push, I guess, but the ball was loose.
I think, nope.
Not sure what Keogh did that was illegal there.
I'm with you on that one. Certainly, maybe, is the ball too far away? I don't think you could call that. So Syracuse, with an opportunity to make it a two-goal lead. They'll be patient for 30 seconds as we play five on five, and then they'll go to work on the extra man. So this is Thompson, drawing out Malphus. And there's a push with possession, so they're going to be two man up in a little bit. So now it's a free possession for Syracuse. Thompson gets a step, but Gilman makes the save. And Lovejoy with the ground ball stops the possession. So now a critical moment here for Dom Starja. Down by a goal.
3-0. 1 minute trip. 1 minute foul.
And it's a trip on Malphus.
Both these goalies turned it up a notch.
So it'll be 6-on-4 here. Quint, what's the strategy when you're down two men in the square with just four people out there?
Well, you box it up, and it will shift from a box formation. You see the four men in the blue jerseys in front of their goalie. It will, at times, could change into a diamond formation as well. But you want to keep it tight, keep the ball on the perimeter, force a shot from the wing that your goalie is most comfortable with. Right now, if I'm Adam Gittleman, I'm telling him my defense. I don't want Amadon shooting number 9 in white. I'd much rather see it come from Thompson or from the right wing. Do nothing inside and make sure number 9, Amadon, doesn't get to set his feet from about 12 yards because he can absolutely let it rip.
So 24 seconds of 6-on-4 lacrosse so far tonight. The Syracuse extra man unit 0-for-4, 2-for-12 on the season. Last year in this matchup, they scored 5 extra man goals in the first half.
Penalties were a big storyline early in that game last year.
So now we're all set. Desko gets it behind to Keogh. Amadon. Here's an opportunity for Desko.
Good defense. Excellent job by Virginia. Desko's an attackman. Doesn't have the kind of range.
So 9 seconds left for the 6-on-4.
Thompson, extra pass. Here's a shot, not on Cage. Let's check in with Paul right now.
Well, Quint, you mentioned when you're down two, extra man here for Syracuse, 6-on-4. Coach Starza emphasizing stay home, no rotations. Stay in the box, do not overcommit.
So McWilliams comes out on Marasco, and Gittleman comes up with the ground ball. But a quick call, loose ball push on Virginia gives it back to Syracuse. So now the first penalty is released. So now it's 6-on-5 with Malfris in the box. JoJo sneaking along now. Desco gets another look, and Gittleman makes the save on the high-to-high shot. He saw that one.
He's all over that.
And now we got an interference call on Keough, so it'll be a free clear.
After a slow start, that man right there, Adam Gittleman, has been unbelievable. Zero saves in the first quarter, six in the second quarter, and five already for a total of 11 stops. So, gaining momentum.
So the rivalry, inside the rivalry, Gittleman and Galloway, the same class, both in New York State. Gittleman out of Cold Spring Harbor, Galloway out of West Genesee. Here's Briggs going hard to the cage. In high school, it was Gittleman who had the loftier reputation, made the U19 team, won a state championship, but in college, it's been reversed with Galloway winning two titles. Stanwyck gets a step, but can't get the shot off. Good ride there by Bocklet to force the loose ball. Wade scooches it across midfield. Syracuse, Virginia's going to have to get it back in the box at some point. But Virginia will take over. Syracuse will take over. The college lacrosse action continues on ESPNU as number 10 Princeton travels to Baltimore to take on number 8 Johns Hopkins. 1 o'clock Saturday, Old Spice College Lacrosse from historic Homewood Field.
Joe Beninati, Jamie Monroe, and Jesse Schwartzman in the booth. Princeton brings their pairs offense, a lot of pick and roll game, and a very, very good defense with guys like Chad Wiedmeyer and John Cunningham into Homewood Field.
Good check by LaPierre.
The Blue Jays off to a very good start for Dave Petromala and that young team. Very impressed with what I saw from John Rannigan and John Greeley so far this year.
It's only the first weekend of March, but that's still a critical game barometer for both teams because Princeton has a brutal early season schedule.
Princeton, that game means an awful lot to the Princeton Tigers because of what they're looking at ahead on their schedule.
North Carolina comes to Princeton
on March
10th.
Villanova, the most improved team in the country in Penn. Later in the year, they still have to play Syracuse and obviously Cornell.
Chris Bates in his second year with the Tigers. This is Halden from behind. Deed up by Kevin Drew. Rommel, feet inside, tough, knocked away by Syracuse. Looking for Cockerton. Number 1 Syracuse with a 1-goal lead on number 2 Virginia at the Carrier Dome. The 27th meeting between these two storied programs in college lacrosse. Eamon McEnany along with Quint Kesnick and Paul Carcaterra. Several momentum swings in this game. Syracuse had the early lead. Virginia dominated the second quarter, and so far Syracuse has had the upper hand in the third. White gets checked by Bratton. Virginia has dominated the series of late, but that one win, of course, Quint, a very big win for Syracuse up in Foxborough.
2008 national semifinal where Mike Lavelle scored 5 goals on their way to a national title a year after a sub-500 record. And you look at the Syracuse program, they really struggled in 05, 06, 07. But the senior class has been really, really strong. Amazing record that they've put up.
That shot by Ryan Barber, stopped by Gittleman. And Paul told us earlier, Coach Desco wants his team to change levels. So far, they're going high to high right now. Rommel thought about pulling the trigger. Now he backs up.
Seems like Rommel has been on the field the entire game. He's played a very strong game.
LaPierre has also been out there a lot. He gives it up. Here's Stanwyck. Looking for Bocklet. Instead, he gets it to Shamel Bratton. Shamel keeps it. Good stop there.
More of a power dodge by Shamel. Usually likes to shake. That time he dropped his right shoulder and tried to beat White by running through him.
So a slow third quarter here for Virginia after dominating the second quarter with four goals. Shamel loses it. Gets it over to Stanley. Now Shamel, duck under.
Whoa, oh my gosh!
Wow, what a worm burner. How did he get that off?
Letting his play, doing the talking. As you see him sprint off the field, that's his signature. Watch the little subtle hitch right here. Right there, his ability to control the ball in his stick, maintain his focus on the goal while falling down in traffic. Move, White is over aggressive. He can re-trigger and get that shot off before the double team comes. A sensational goal by Shamel.
He now has three. It's a good article in Inside Lacrosse during the preseason as they push it forward and then knock it back to White. So a clean win on the faceoff by Daddio. The Brattons during the preseason talking about winning one. I mean, there was so much hype when they went to Virginia.
Yeah, the expectations, the hype, been tough to live up to. They have made three championship weekends consecutively. Dom Starja asking them to be better leaders this year. Help their teammates more, especially the young guys. Bring them along.
Here's Marasco from up top. Gittleman with the save, and now he's out in the open field. Gittleman gets by and then dumps it off. Adam Gittleman locked in right now. 13 saves for the senior out of Long Island. And then point back to the Brattons. You read those quotes, you read that article about being focused. And then they are kept home in Charlottesville for the Stony Brook game.
Violation of team rules, and I can speak from a personal experience where I was suspended my sophomore year. Similar incident. It's unselfish. It's immature. It's flat out stupid. But for a senior, it really shocks me. Shamel and Rommel need to put themselves behind the good of the team.
Galloway. Good anticipation there to come up with the turnover. Virginia winning that game in overtime when Steele Stanwyck scored his fifth goal of the game. Now Amidon being guarded by Emery. That might be a matchup Syracuse wants to take a run at.
Never want to hurt your teammates, your team, coaching staff, the school, and with all the speculation on the Brattons, they're seniors now. They should understand that. Everybody's watching them. Although it might not be fair, that's the scrutiny that comes with who they are.
So this is Thompson being guarded by Wyatt Meltzer.
And last thing I'll say is, in my life, that incident was a huge positive in changing my behavior. And you hope that, as a young adult, that they learn their lesson as well.
Thompson rolls back to his right, makes the pass to Desco. He's in on the doorstep, and he beats Gittleman for his fourth of the night.
You wondered when Gittleman was going to have that momentarily lapse. Thompson draws a triple team. And the team defense behind it, the recovery phase is not there. Desco takes advantage of all the attention going to Thompson.
Syracuse has the lead. Let's check in with Paul.
Well, two of the best Dodgers on the field here tonight. Shamel Bratton, number one for Virginia, number 22 in White for Syracuse, Jojo Marasco. The thing in common, they sell the defense to the opposite side. Both are left-handed players. They get the defense to commit to the right, and they get low and explode out, almost like a crossover in basketball, dominating the dodge with change of direction.
Paul looking like he's ready for the alumni game afterwards. He's ready to go.
These jerseys from his era, so he should feel pretty comfortable.
Throwback jerseys tonight. Here's Harris. Shot, save, Gittleman. Keo denied on the fast break.
Another example of a Syracuse shot. No change of levels. Pretty easy save. Stick side, eye level.
Edelman now has 14. His team is down by a goal. 3 minutes to play in the third quarter. Who's waking up tomorrow is the number one team in the country. There's Shamel back to his right. Now the swim move to his left off the cage. Shamel Bratton. And LaPierre, the midfield unit, out there along with Cockerton, Bocklet, and Stanwyck. Here's Ramel Bratton being guarded by Drew. Now he finds his brother open in space. Good recovery defense by the freshman, Harris.
He's so bouncy. There's that change of direction.
Back to his left. Gets it to his brother, Harris. Matt Harris has come alive here and giving Syracuse some quality minutes.
Loved him last summer when we saw him at the ESPN Rise Senior Showcase in Orlando. From Illinois. He can flat out play 44 in white.
There's a run through a pick there on Stanwyck. No call. LaPierre driving in on Harder. Fans looking for a Ward. They appreciate the good defense. Feed inside, Stanwyck gets the shot blocked by Lade. So a good stop by Syracuse, and the crowd rises as one here at the Dome. Now Amidon. The third quarter has been carried by Syracuse. Hollison. A goal on this possession in this place might erupt as you hear the students chant, "Let's go Orange." Nick Williams all over Desco, no call. The freshman, and now there's a call. So Kevin O'Leary closer to the ball, didn't make a call, but the other official, Steve Miller, did. So Syracuse will hold on to it. Under a minute to play here in the third quarter. Number one with the ball and the lead on number two. Seconds left in the quarter. Palasek gets a step on Lovejoy. Looking to feed. Gets it through. Regalo. Amidon could not keep it in his stick. So now 25 seconds. Malfris looking for the clear. Good ride by Kia. Into the middle of the field. That's a dangerous pass. Huge opportunity if Desco can come up with it. Good hit there. Marasco comes in with some contact. 13 seconds left. Now Desco picks it up. He's got Palasek. Palasek shoots. We heard a whistle, yes, absolutely, away from the ball, interference. And now we're going to talk it over. Kevin O'Leary's got a penalty. Someone's going to the box. If I could read lips correctly, I think he said 2-1 white.
Number 28, white. 1 minute and a third.
So it's on Keo, 28.
You can sense the intensity, I hope, at home, because it's here in this building. The electricity has been raised a notch. Sloppy clear by Virginia.
Quinn, is that too far away from the ball there on that hit on Bobby Hill?
Not sure. Couldn't see the ball in the frame.
The fans just saw the replay here.
Keo limps into the penalty box.
So now with 6 seconds, what's the strategy for Virginia?
They will hold the ball here.
So that'll do it for a third quarter. Syracuse carries the action in the third quarter to take a one-goal lead into the final 15 minutes. Will it be the final 15 minutes? Or will we have bonus lacrosse at the Carrier Dome? Number one, living up to the billing, but right now the coach's son has 4 and his dad has the lead. We'll be right back.
This is my car. This is where I sleep. This is where we eat. This is where I run my home business. And so can you.
Hit it!
Small businesses are driving today's economy, and home-based businesses are a multi-billion dollar industry. All you have to do is log on to the website on your screen now to get started.
All you need is an internet connection, some desire, and you can run this business from anywhere.
My first month, I made over $2,700 profit.
You can get started right away. Log on now and we'll send you your free internet starter pack that will guide you through the step-by-step process to setting up your own home-based business.
If I can do it, you can do it. Get your internet starter pack today.
You could be making money wherever you are, right now. What are you waiting for?
Log on now and get your free internet starter pack today.
And this one continues the trend of a close affair between Virginia and Syracuse, as Syracuse, looking to snap a three-game losing streak at home to the Cavs, has a one-goal lead, but Virginia will open up the fourth quarter with an extra man opportunity. The 27th all-time meeting between these two great programs, and right now the all-time score, 363-363. One-goal games have been the norm in this rivalry recently. Last year down in Charlottesville, a one-goal game. A semifinal affair was an overtime game, but now an extra man opportunity. Guadagnolo knocks down the pass. This is White. Pass knocked down.
Guadagnolo, what a series.
Two very active plays with his stick.
Stick in the passing lane, twice deflecting the ball. That's all you want on your man down team. 42 in White, that hand-eye coordination, air traffic control. Great defense.
We would like to apologize for the audio difficulties that we've been experiencing here at the Carrier Dome. I think we have the kinks all worked out. And back to that man down play by Guadagnolo. Coach couldn't say enough nice things about the senior, who his brother was a captain here, and he's worked his way up to the starting ranks.
In typical Syracuse fashion, they develop players, guys who don't play much freshman and sophomore year. They give them a very specific role. They get some PT later on, and then they become starters and potential stars.
Aminon lets one fly way off the mark. He's been quiet from outside tonight. So Meltzer, Emery, and LaPierre out there defensively at the midfield. See if they take a run at the freshman here with the senior Thompson. Thompson picks up the pace. Good switch and a check there. Meltzer goes for the check. Thompson driving hard. That's a goal. Determination and the late hit.
Thompson looks explosive and a step faster this season. Question for him, because he faces off so much. No face off, that's right. Because Thompson faces off so much, tend to get the wear and tear and the grind of the season. But here, he just makes up his mind. I'm going to the goal, you're gonna have to take me down.
You see McWilliams there coming in with the cross check high, so he'll go to the penalty box. So a huge turn of events right now as Syracuse with a two-goal lead and an extra man opportunity. No face-off. They'll start with the ball. What an individual effort by Thompson, showing why he was the sixth overall pick in the Major League Lacrosse draft for the Toronto Nationals. Let's check in with Paul before this extra man opportunity for the Cuse.
Well, if you look at all the penalty flags flying, this game is seriously physical. Both teams are getting after it, hitting after plays. A lot of chirping, too. When a player comes into the penalty box, both teams getting after each other from the restraining box area. Talking a little bit of smack down here. This game is pretty intense.
Absolutely. So now The Syracuse extra man unit has not cashed in yet tonight. A goal here would be huge, because a three-goal lead in this ball game right now would feel like a 5 or 7 goal lead in another game. It's been so tight. 0 for 6 on the EMO for the team in white.
This game has always been such a great barometer for both these programs. Played early in the year. Where do we stand? What do we need to work on? Who looks good?
Gilbert gives it back to Amidon.
Kind of the litmus test for both coaches early in the year.
Thompson wants it up top. He's got it. He's going to work it back to his left. Shoot. Good check there. And Gittleman hustles to the end line. So great hustle by the senior goalie. Just a step faster than Jeff Gilbert. So now with 18 seconds left, Virginia will look to clear.
You're in no rush here.
No rush. 30 seconds to get it in the box. The new rules. And Lovejoy completes the pass to Rommel. So the penalty is over. 0 for 7 now for Syracuse.
Gittleman is the seventh defender. He's active. Ground balls. Stole a possession there. He can pick off passes. A goalie must be more than just a stopper.
Under 12 minutes to play in regulation. The number two team in the country with the ball, down by two. Here is Shamel Bratton taking another run at White. He loses him. Draws the slide. Back to his left. The slide doesn't come in time. Look out. That one's going up. Thought it was going up to the second deck. And now he's limping a little bit. Shamel Bratton coming off the field. It's been a drought for Virginia. And now they trail by two. And that's called a shot. So Shamel Bratton limps off the field. Replaced by John Haldy. You see the training staff taking a look at him. Here's Stanwyck. Two-man game to Rommel. He going to crease? He did. Did not know where he was. Quick restart. Here is White. White with a full head of steam in the open field. Wide open is Palasek. What a save by Gittleman. Now we go the other way. Could this be a two-goal swing? Good transition recovery defense by the Orange. 14 saves for Adam Gittleman. Now here's Briggs. Briggs gets a step on White. Good over the head check by number 11 there. As we approach 10 minutes without a goal for the number two team in the country.
See, Gittleman, not the tallest character in the net, has that low stance and actually dropped his stick, baiting the high shot at the last moment. Boom, pops that stick up. Thank you very much. Zero saves in the first quarter for the young man from Virginia. Since then, stellar, spectacular.
But his team needs a goal, coming in averaging 17 goals a game. They are not used to droughts like this. Who will provide the offense? Here's Haldy. Being guarded by Tim Harder. Now Briggs loses Drew. Doesn't like his angle, so he gives it up. Stanwyck with the bounce shot. Galloway got a piece. And Harder there for the backup. We're going the other way. So the drought continues for Stanwyck and the Cavaliers.
They love their D. Of all the great Syracuse teams, last year's may have had one of the top defenses. Number one in scoring margin, scoring defense in the country. For a program that's renowned for high scoring offense. So there's been a subtle shift because of the strong personnel on the defensive end. Guys like John Lade, Gill, and Joel White.
Well, Coach Desko's been honest. They started recruiting harder on the defensive end, going hard after a guy like McGill or Lade when he was transferring from Villanova. And you cannot underscore the addition of Leland Rogers to the coaching staff.
Tighten things up from a team defense standpoint.
Syracuse looking to go up by three now with under 10 minutes to play in the fourth quarter. Here's Palasek. Amidon makes the catch. Now Marasco from up top with Malfris on him.
little patience now, both teams employing in the half field set to rest their defensive legs.
Jovan Miller driving hard to the right, shot off, just skips past Gittleman. Palasek looking for the quick feed, but nobody open. Here's Desko, playing with confidence right now. Shot! He's got five! Having a hard time getting up off the ground after beating Gittleman for the fifth time. Now he comes to his feet.
Just beats his man topside. Defensively, you want to turn that man. Even though Desko is a left-handed player, you've got to get that stick up and underneath the hands. The adjacent defender, who in that case was Clements, number two in blue, can show and fake slide. He should step down from the right side of your screen.
So danger time now for the Cavaliers, down by three.
Think about the way Notre Dame played defense 2 weeks ago when we saw them. They have a lot of adjacent near man slides, fake slides also, what they call ghost slides. Well, they'll take a step or two towards the ball carrier as a deterrent.
The Irish will pay a visit to the Carrier Dome on April 30th. You'll be able to see that Big East showdown on ESPNU. And if things go as planned right now, that'll be a top five meeting.
On paper, Notre Dame will be favored in their first 10 games this year.
The Irish have Drexel this weekend.
The games aren't played on paper. Just ask the Penn Quakers.
Penn knocking off Duke and Bucknell for an impressive start to the season. So you saw Coach Desko after that goal say settle down, in no rush with a three-goal lead. Second midfield unit out there with Thompson.
Little stagnant off ball. Thompson sniffing out that ISO, but nothing's going on away from the ball.
Thompson, Coleman, and Gilbert at the midfield. Marasco, Palasek, and Keogh at the attack. This is Palasek looking for the inside roll. Lovejoy all over him, and he comes up with a turnover. Palasek can't keep it in bounds. The college lacrosse action continues on ESPNU at 1 o'clock tomorrow from historic Homewood Field as the 8th-ranked Johns Hopkins Blue Jays host number 10 Princeton. That's Old Spice College Lacrosse from Baltimore tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock. Princeton looks to even up its record at 1-1 after a tough road loss at Hofstra.
Dave Petromala on the ESPNU podcast told me this week, we've got to find ways to score goals other than the 6-on-6. Got to push the transition, 4-on-4 and 5-on-5s, and we have to capitalize with the extra man.
Right now in this one, Virginia has to find a way to score a goal. They've played more than 13 minutes without putting one past Galloway. Here's Stanwyck with a tough angle shot.
Stanwyck's been a little quiet. He's got to exert himself. Challenge lead. Draw a double team, things will open up.
Plenty of time left for this Virginia offense to get going as we approach the 7-minute mark. There it is. Steele Stanwyck, one goal on five shots, looking to be more of a creator and a feeder. Here's Haldy. Driving on harder. Gives it up. And an unforced error. But Lovejoy there to bail his offense out. Drew all over the defenseman. Lovejoy had to get it back in the box, and you saw him tiptoe, he came out. So good defense by Syracuse. Not what Virginia was looking for at all there as we approach 6.5 minutes left in the ballgame. Quinn, I know it's maybe sound like sacrilege to say this in this rivalry and in this building, but when do you slow things down if you're Syracuse with a three-goal lead?
Well, they have already. They're chewing about 30 seconds every time they start a new possession. They are taking their extreme time in their substitution patterns, and the referees are going to have to look around now and start to maybe say, guys, keep it in. You are not attacking the goal.
Let's send it down to Paul.
Well, Syracuse and the seniors really want this game. Not able to beat Virginia in the regular season. I spoke to John Galloway this week after losing to Army last season in the first round. I asked him, how is it different with this offseason? He mentioned instead of basking in the high of winning the national championship, guys were chomping at the bit to get back on the field and return the Orange to glory. The quote the team adopted pretty quickly, what do you fear more, the pain of hard work or the pain of regret?
All right, Paul, thanks a lot. Here's Jovan Miller lining up Ramel Bratton behind the cage on an invert. Talking to Joel White about not beating Virginia except for the semifinal game. He said it really clicked in that this was his final year at Syracuse when he was drafted by the Rattlers as Miller gets a step and draws the flag.
He has his head taken off.
Jovan also a high pick by the Rattlers. Eighth overall in Major League Lacrosse, drawing another flag. And Jim O'Hara explains. So Dom Starge's club down by three with 5 minutes left, now facing a man down. And really, Syracuse can just be very patient here, down a man with a minute. Up a man for a minute here.
Not a good time for a foul if you're Virginia. Takes discipline to hit a man without cross-checking. And there's a special emphasis this year, targeting the head and neck. Players have to adjust and know that the refs are going to be strict in that department.
Number one Syracuse with a 3-goal lead on number two Virginia. An extra man opportunity for the Orange. Looking to start sealing the deal here at home. Coming up next, it's Championship Week presented by Dick's Sporting Goods, the Ohio Valley Men's Tournament semifinal action, Tennessee Tech against Murray State. Feed inside, Keogh gets denied. So Gittleman goes down low and stops the shot. Now look at the Jets from Ramel Bratton. The one man clear, loses a stick, shot, hits a knock-in.
What a play. 60-yard dash. Bratton ran by four opponents.
And now the ball's in the stick of his brother. Go. 4 minutes left in regulation. Virginia with the ball down by three. Another missed opportunity for Syracuse on the extra man. Here's Emery. White can't make the catch on the tough pass. Wade picks up the ground ball. Thompson, though, loses it. Key ground ball here. Still loose. Clements pushing it forward, and it ends up in Emery. Now unsettled, going the other way. Here's Shamel, shake and bake, sees the double coming. Joel White, Shamel Bratt, All-American against All-American here as we approach the three-minute mark.
Virginia standing around and watching Shamel operate.
Gets free and scores. That will silence the Carrier Dome. And he is limping off the field once again. But boy, did he patiently set that one up.
Again, you can see it coming a mile away. Turns the corner left-handed. Double team is late. Dips underneath. Jim changes hips there and kind of drop his shoulders. And as Joel White makes contact, it's almost as if Shamel kind of ducks underneath that contact, and that allows him to turn the corner.
You see him cramping up there, it looks like, as they rub his calves. I'm curious if Virginia wins the faceoff here, if they take a timeout to try to give him some extra time. And LaPierre wins it cleanly. So it's a 2-goal game with 2:45. And
nice call.
Happens every once in a while. Dom Starja takes a timeout. 22 goals already. Do we have any more left in the Carrier Dome? We're back after this.
What do you think about Coach Knight's call at the end? It was on the line.
That's ridiculous.
We gotta call him. We gotta ask him about this. Coach! It was on the line.
Excuse me? Hang on. I'm gonna call an expert.
Man, did you see that call that Bobby made?
What do you mean we missed the call on the 3 points?
I can't believe you did that.
What are you looking at?
Man, that was great.
Are you drinking tonight?
Don't you hate it when she's right? To learn more, go to ontheline.com, because your health is on the line.
Introducing the all-new Sobakawa Cloud Pillow, a pillow 300 years in the making, based on the traditional Asian buckwheat pillow. The Sobakawa Cloud is filled with over 10 million air beads, a virtual sea of clouds. It does three things no other pillow does: gives adjustable support, cools your head, and never breaks down. We placed eggs on the bottom of these cylinders, filled this cylinder with feathers from an expensive pillow. This 10-pound weight crushes the feathers and smashes the eggs. In this tube, we have stuffing from a fiber pillow, and it offers little resistance. Then we tried memory foam, and the weight wins again. Now watch as the weight hits the air beads. They absorb the shock, and the eggs are safe. Order your Sobakawa Cloud Pillow for just $19.99. Call right now, and we'll double your order. You'll receive a second Sobakawa pillow and pillowcase for just the shipping and handling. But you have to call now.
To order your Sobakawa Cloud Pillow, have your credit card ready, and call 1-800-899-2598. That's 1-800-899-2598.
Do you want to own a brand new HP, Dell, or other name brand computer and improve your credit at the same time? If so, Tronics Country says you're approved, guaranteed.
I wanted a new computer, but I couldn't get financed. Then I called Tronics Country. They approved me, delivered my new computer, and are reporting on my credit.
If you have an active checking account and can afford low, flexible payments, you're already approved, guaranteed, for this special offer. There's no credit check, so you won't be turned down.
Tronics Country approved me quickly.
I got instant approval, and it was easy.
Their flexible payment plans made it easy on my budget, and my kids are getting ahead in school.
I started my own business, and now I'm my own boss.
Call now, and with your paid order, we'll add a free color printer, free MP3 music player, and free LCD TV. You heard right. Free printer, free MP3 player, and free LCD TV. Call now and tell us where you want your brand new computer and free gift shipped today.
I'm glad I called.
Hi, I'm Mike Gleason inside the ESPNU studios. Thanks for watching ESPNU. For more information on this program and other ESPN sporting events, log on to ESPNU.com. We'll return to more action in this event after these messages.
The second annual ESPNU Warrior Classic returns to East Hartford, Connecticut on Saturday, April 23rd. Don't miss this top-level lacrosse doubleheader. UMass is back in search of a repeat victory, but will lacrosse powerhouse Hofstra be too much to handle? Then, 10-time national champion Syracuse faces up-and-coming Big East rival Rutgers. Be there April 23rd at Rensselaer Field. Get your tickets now. Call 1-800-745-3000 or visit Ticketmaster.com today.
I'm snow, and just like you, the further into winter we go, the heavier I get. And while your pants struggle to support the heavier you, your roof struggles to support the heavier me. When your cut rate insurance might not pay for this, it's a good Allstate. You can save money and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Dollar for dollar, nobody protects you from mayhem like Allstate.
Nothing compares to Pizza Hut's world-famous pan pizza with a delicious deep golden crust baked in a seasoned pan until it's crispy on the outside and soft on the inside. And now, for a limited time, choose any pan pizza, any size, with any of your favorite toppings for just $10. Even specialty pan pizzas, like a large Meat Lover's or a large Supreme. Add a 2-liter Pepsi and an order of breadsticks for just $5 more. The legendary pan pizza, now only $10 and only at your Pizza Hut.
Look closely. This $50 Buffalo gold piece is the first United States coin ever struck using .9999, that's four nines, pure 24-karat gold. The U.S. government had to stop production because of a shortage of specially made gold blanks. It's no wonder the price of this edition is going through the roof. Now, you can reserve your own copy clad in 14 milligrams of pure gold. The final issue price was to be set at $50 per proof, but now this private non-monetary gold clad masterpiece can be yours for only $9.95. With gold skyrocketing, price can only be guaranteed for 7 days. Each 2011 Gold Buffalo Tribute proof is clad in 14 milligrams of pure gold, is proof struck, and utilizes the famous Buffalo nickel design. Strict limit of 5 proofs per caller. You must hurry. Call now.
To order, call 1-800-710-4520. That's 1-800-710-4520. 1-800-710-4520.
Old Spice College Lacrosse is brought to you by Old Spice Matterhorn. Become one of the freshest smelling places on earth. And in part by Sector Spiders ETFs. Visit them on the web at sectorspiders.com. Welcome back to Syracuse. Number one Orange with a 2-goal lead with a minute 20 left as we take a look back at a big night for Tim Desko. 5 goals for the junior out of West Genesee High School. And some very creative once again.
Catch and shoot from inside, able to handle the pressure. Flair for the fancy. 5 goals on 8 shots.
So a career high night for Tim Desko makes him tonight's Maverick player of the game. 5 goals off just 8 shots.
Virginia will come with the pressure here right away. Jovan Miller facing a double team.
So Miller starts the run to daylight. Clements waiting to pounce on the double team. And he beats them both. And now they have to keep it in the box. McWilliams is going to the box. That's an easy call. And Miller still has it. Miller holding on to it. Flags all over the place. This could get ugly right now.
Maintain your composure.
And just as you said it, Jovan Miller did not. So he may go to the box to wipe off this extra man. Although who knows how many penalties are going to be on Virginia at the end of this. The crowd of over 14,000 sensing the moment right now. So many flags out there that one of the officials, I think it was Jim O'Hara, had to throw his hat. Never a good sign when they get the pencil and the notepad out.
Kevin O'Leary, Joe Von Miller, that's a cross check in the back of the net. That's a foul.
There's just another one.
Nothing yet.
There's a cross check by Gettleman.
Right. That's a tackle by Gettleman and probably a slash. Could be as many as 4 fouls, and that should be one also on Jovan Miller, who I can understand his frustration, but you got to take a deep breath and exhale.
So Gettleman goes to the box. All 3 players going to the box from Virginia, serenaded by the crowd.
27. I got 2-7, blue, unnecessary 1. I got 3-0, blue, unnecessary 1. I got 8, blue, unnecessary 1. I got 23, white, unsportsmanlike conduct, 2 minutes, full time. No, it was not that. West, let me think about it for a second.
Look at Steele Stanwyck. Six selling, and blue.
He's selling.
He knows the rules better than the refs.
He said it was a dead ball.
Dead ball, so it's blue ball.
He knows the rules better than the refs. There he is.
How about Kevin O'Leary?
So Jovan Miller, because his foul was the last and the ball was dead. Steele Stanwyck's there.
Well, right now it's in the stick of Jeremy Thompson, so they're going to have to. I love the audio. Kevin O'Leary, give me a second to straighten this out.
Cameraman Jeff down there in the audio that picked up. Now, Virginia's got a situation here where they got 3 guys in the penalty box. They'll be playing without midfielders. Is that possible? That all of their players will have to stay back and they'll be operating with only 3 on offense? Is that possible?
We'll have to take a look. Dom Starch is going to try to figure it out as there's a timeout in the field.
get them in Malfrus.
And Mick Williams.
And the freshman Mick Williams in the penalty box. So they have seven. So on this clear, nobody, not even the ball carrier, can cross the midfield line. You got to have four back in your defensive zone there, Eamon.
There you go. Seconds left there is Leland Rogers.
Yeah, listening to Coach Rogers, he just said technically it's a 5-on-3, which it will be because Syracuse is down one as well.
So you've got two on the ball, three covering their attack, one is a bend.
Paul Carcaterra is going to try to help us organize this thing.
Well, you have to be a mathematician to figure this one out, but basically in a nutshell what has happened is Virginia had three fouls, three slashes. However, Syracuse retaliated with an unsportsmanlike after the retaliation foul, then goes to Virginia. They're playing three man down, but do have the ball because of the retaliation foul on Syracuse.
The clear is key here as you look at the violations. Virginia now accruing 10 penalties.
But they will start. Dom Starge's lobbing to start at midfield.
Right, watch. Here comes the whistle blows. And right there, Jovan Miller, 23 and white. And there are awarding Virginia a free clear, I believe.
On the penalty. 10 penalties.
Yeah.
That's a shot no coach likes. Two seniors and a freshman in the box, down by two with a minute with 57 seconds left. So LaPierre tries to split the double team.
He does!
What an athletic effort. But then he loses it. Galloway comes out. Galloway's going to get hit. That's clean until as soon as I say that, there's a flag. So LaPierre must have led with the stick.
You and cannot hit a man while he's down on the ground. First of all, LaPierre, an amazing play. An inch away from pulling this off. The hit was high. And you're not allowed to hit a man while he's down on the ground.
Penalty number 11 of the evening for Virginia. LaPierre gets through two.
Triple team.
Then he gets up again. Right there, he loses it. Hustles back.
Right there with the cross check. Again, it is a point of emphasis this year, targeting of the head and neck with your head, your fist, or cross checks are going to get called every time this year. And I hope the other 59 Division I teams are watching because there's going to be zero tolerance this year. Concussions in the NFL and college lacrosse are now being dealt with. And beware, it's going to get called. Learn to hit properly.
So 5-on-3 lacrosse with 38 seconds left. Should make this one all but academic here at the Carrier Dome. Quinn, as we wrap this thing up, what have you learned? You said they use it as a litmus test. Both teams learn from this game. What have you learned?
Need to see a little more offense from Virginia that's not Shamel Bratton. I actually thought their close defense, given the inexperience, McWilliams the freshman, Clements, really no experience prior to this year, thought they accounted for themselves very well. And Syracuse is really good. We knew that. They'll maintain their number one status. The framework is defense. Today it was Timmy Desko. Never would have guessed that.
So a big night for Syracuse lacrosse as a local product. And the son of the coach comes up with five goals. They rock the throwback unis. And they will remain number one. It's over at the Carrier Dome. They run to Galloway. Syracuse remains undefeated, knocking off Virginia 12-10. Once again, our final score, number one, Syracuse, 12. Number two, Virginia, 10. Up next, Tennessee Tech against Murray State in semifinal action of the Ohio Valley Men's Tournament. This has been an exclusive presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Now let's go to Nashville, Tennessee.